Portion distortion contributes to obesity. A new study finds that young adults are serving up significantly larger portions for themselves than they did 20 years ago. And this portion distortion may contribute to the current obesity epidemic. As reported in the Journal of American Dietetic Association study, participants chose significantly larger portions of cornflakes, milk on cereal, orange juice, and fruits, as well as salad, than the counterparts in 1984. Conversely, they chose smaller portions of sugar and salad dressing than their counterparts also. Researchers suggest that the growth in portion size offered in grocery stores and restaurants have distorted how people view the appropriate amount of food to eat per servings. Take a serving of orange juice, for example. A standard portion size as found in a grocery store or restaurant in a carton is 8 ounces or half a cup. Yet when you buy them, you can buy single serving sizes that actually contain 2.2 cups of orange juice. This is a size that wasn't available 20 years ago. With the growth of portion size, ready-to-serve foods as well as restaurant servings over the past two decades, people have followed suit when it comes to dishing up their own helpings at home. The report concludes that getting portion size under control and displaying more prominently the number of actual servings on single-serving containers would help combat the growing diet-related problems in this country. The source of this article and information is the Journal of American Dietetic Association, September 2006. Absolutely no one covers this topic better than the book of the month, Mindless Eating by Dr. Brian Wansick. The book clearly covers many factors you'll never think of that continues to hold on those extra 5, 10, 20, 50 pounds under your belly, hips, and rear end. You must be just one or two ideas away. You might just be. It might be something simple. So Mindless Eating is a great book to pick up to turn you around, give you some extra education. This is Dr. Benzinger on health for secondopinion.org.